Hi, it's Deacon Andrew here with our devotion for today. It's good to be with you all. Our devotion comes from Psalm 33, and I'm going to read two passages from within the psalm. First is going to be verses 4 and 5, and then I'm going to jump down to verses 20, 21, and 22. So let's hear a word from God today. For the word of the Lord is upright, and all his work is done in faithfulness. God loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of the steadfast love of the Lord. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and shield. Our heart is glad in him because we trust in his holy name. Let your steadfast love, O Lord, be upon us, even as we hope in you. Word of God, word of life. So as I was getting ready for the devotion, the text is all of Psalm 33, which is a lot more room than we have in a devotion. It's 22 whole verses. So I decided to pull a couple of verses out of it that seemed to have an element of a message for us to hear today. And I actually decided on two passages. And the first was that verse 4 and 5. And then the second was all the way down toward the end of the psalm, Psalm 20, 21, and 22. And when I did that, and I copied and pasted those and put those on a script, what I recognized was there's a phrase that shows up in both places that really ties this whole psalm together. And that phrase is steadfast love. It occurs at the end of verse 5, where it says, God loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of the steadfast love of the Lord. And then it shows back up at the end of the psalm in verse 22, the last verse, where it says, let your steadfast love, O Lord, be upon us, even as we hope in you. That's actually a literary device called an inclusio, where somebody kind of put something at the beginning and at the end that mirrors one another. And this phrase, steadfast love, is in the beginning and then the end of this psalm. And then everything in it is kind of an unpacking, in this case, of what is that steadfast love? What does it look like? And we hear about faithfulness and righteousness and justice, and that the whole earth is full of God's steadfast love because God is the one that created the whole earth. And then it talks about our world and the nations and how we think we can trust in all of these different external factors and influences in our world. But really the only thing that is sure, the only thing that is certain, the only thing that is true is God and God's steadfast love. And so the psalm concludes after praising God for who God is, to turning on to our situation. It says our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and shield. Our heart is glad in him because we trust in his holy name. And then we pray a prayer, a petition that says, let your steadfast love, this love that you use to create all of the universe and the world and everything that is in it, that is all that is good and pure and true and just and right, let that steadfast love, Lord, be upon us because our hope is in you. So I hope today that you can feel God's steadfast love in the midst of your life. Whatever is going on, wherever you are, whatever is happening, that God is our rock, our shield, our help, the source of our trust. Everything comes from God. And so we hold on to this promise of not only what God does, but really who God is. And that is that God is steadfast love. And everything that God does is out of steadfast love. And we are the ones who can receive that love. And so we pray that that love be upon us because our hope is in God. So I hope you can feel God's steadfast love in your life. And I hope that you can share good news of that steadfast love to people around you who probably need to hear a word of encouragement as well. Please pray with me. God, you are the author and creator of all things. You created everything good, and you created them out of love. And everything that you have made through your steadfast love. as your children, we pray, let that steadfast love rain down upon us. May it surround us. May it comfort us. May it guide us. May it reassure us. May it remind us that our trust, our faith, our hope is in you and you alone, Lord. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Beloved child of God, may God bless you and encourage you. May God guide you and equip you. And may you feel that steadfast love of God in your life as you go out to shine the light of Christ in the world each and every day in faith. May God bless you.